When working with compounds of low solubility or needing to increase reaction rates, you're going to want to heat your reaction mixture, but you're also going to need to maintain the concentration of your reaction throughout. This is where the process of refluxing comes in, where the reaction mixture is heated to boiling, but the vapour is able to condense back into the stock. An example of a chemical reaction that is heated to reflux is this esterification between salicylic acid and acetic anhydride, which in the presence of a proton source and using ethanol as the solvent will produce the well-known analgesic aspirin. Let's talk about how not to set up a reflux reaction and why. In this beaker, I've prepared approximately 150 ml of coloured water and started heating it by setting the hot plate to 15 degrees centigrade above the boiling point of water. As the solution boils, you see that the water vapour is being lost to the surrounding atmosphere, resulting in a continuous reduction in volume of liquid in the beaker, and therefore an increase in concentration of the solution. This is great when you're trying to make a red wine reduction for your dinner, but not when you're conducting a chemical reaction. So to stop the vapour from evaporating into the atmosphere, we need to incorporate a cool surface so that the vapour can condense. Let's look at how to set up a reflux reaction in a safe and efficient way. Using an aluminium block, the heat generated by the hot plate can be transferred very quickly to the reaction mixture without the need to use unsafe transfer fluids such as oil. Integrating a temperature probe allows for the set point temperature to be that of the block. I will use a Findenser to provide a cool surface to facilitate solvent condensing. There is no need for running water or any tubing with this apparatus. I like to use PTFE sleeves to prevent the glass joints sticking together. Now, I simply place the Findenser into the neck of the flask and check the stability of the clamp. Let's heat the block to 120 degrees C and get the flask up to reflux. And there we have safe and sustainable reflux, maintaining the concentration of your reaction throughout.